We have some rock and roll awards coming up, and who better to present the first one than two guys who have had 8 hits from their first 2 albums. This group would be the consummate bar band, except their last album went double platinum. Hot off their Blood, Sweat, and Beers tour, please welcome from Warrant, Jenny Lane and Eric Turner.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Pupkin. We appreciate that. We take it as a compliment. We're here to present the number one album rock track award.
Let's take a look and a listen at this year's nominees.
Three.
Here we go!
Number 2.
To the magic of the moment, dream away in the wind of change.
Number 1.
The number one rock track of the year is Silent Lucidity from the double platinum selling album Empire. Here with the new single, Another Rainy Night, is Queensryche.
Waiting by the fire.
Thank you very much. Well, this is really exciting to be here. First off, we'd like to thank Michael Kamen, who helped orchestrate the music for the song Silent Lucidity. Peter Collins, our producer. James Barton for making it sound the way it does. From the management end, we'd like to thank Cliff Bernstein and Peter Minch from Q Prime and all our staff there for really pushing the record. EMI, our record company, Norm Osborne, Jack Satter, and Jim Colley, and the entire EMI field staff for really promoting the record the way it should have been done in the first place. You guys are great. And thanks again, we appreciate it.
Okay, this next award is for the number one album rock artist. Here is proof that the 80s are over and rock still rules. Check it out.
Into the great wide open.
If you needed somebody.
All this time, I'm losing my religion. No tear grind.
Number 3. Number 2.
Let me light your candle, calls a mama. I'll show all the hell and I'll just around. Yeah.
Number 1.
This year's number one album rock artist has sold over 45 million albums to date, and that's a lot of rock. 2 million of those were For Unlawful Carnal Knowledge, the album that shot into the charts at the number one position. This is their third consecutive number one album, and it gave them three number one rock tracks, Pound Cake, Run Around, and Top of the World. For Unlawful Carnal Knowledge, can you say that on television? Can you say knowledge? You can? All right. The number one rock album artist this year is Van Halen. Well, it seems that Eddie, Alex, Sammy, and Michael are on tour, naturally. They're in Memphis, actually. But I'm going to present them their award through the magic of modern technology. Guys, here you go.
Well, thank you, Paul.
Hey, Paul.
Hi, Paul. Anyway, the reason I like this award personally is because we are an album band. We like to make albums and we like to play rock concerts and just have fun amongst us. And that's about it. We're not like a hit top singles kind of band. But so being an album band, album artist, I think it's an honor. And our fans are the ones who buy the albums without hearing the singles. And we've had number one albums because of our fans. And we pack Coliseums because of our fans. And we enjoy doing it. They're the ones who deserve the thanks. Ed Leffler and Warner Brothers, everybody, I'm sure. But mainly these
Andy,
guys.
Ted, hey, Lenny.
Hey,
you're welcome.
Ed,
you're welcome.
I want to thank Mike, Alex, I want to thank
you. Here to present the next award is the only solo artist in rock ever to hit the top five with each of his first seven singles. His first two albums sold over 10 million copies worldwide, and he was the first new artist ever to be played on 117 radio stations during his first week on the charts. I tell you, the kid gets more airplay than the emergency broadcast system. Here he is, kids, Richard Marx.
How you doing?
Thank you.
This year, one man has dominated the country charts like no one has ever done before, and he didn't stop there.
'Cause I got friends in places where the whiskey drowns and the beer chases my blues away.
He's the first country artist to enter the Billboard 200 Top Albums chart at number one, and his album Rope in the Wind is the first country album to reach number one at all since 1980. It has spent 7 weeks at the top, and that's just one of three albums he currently has on the pop charts. Collectively, they've sold over 11 million records. Big dough, big dough. In his more familiar territory of the country charts, he's had the number one album for 46 weeks and has had six separate number one singles. He made history when he walked away with six Academy of Country Music Awards, so it's no surprise that tonight he wins the awards for the number one country singles artist of the year, the number one country album of the year, the number one country albums artist of the year, the number one country artist, and the first country singer in history to win the number one albums artist award on the Billboard 200 chart. And he's having a good time. I'm honored to introduce Garth Brooks.
Sheesh. This is cool. I like this. This is great.
Yeah!
Thank you very much. Thanks, man. Thank you. I got a million people to thank for this, so I'll never realize all of them or thank all of them. I'd like to thank Capital Nashville and Capital EMI, of course, Pam Lewis and Bob Doyle, my managers, my wonderful wife Sandy, all the great guys, band and crew of Stillwater out there on the road. To Billboard, this top 200 chart you guys came out with saved my ass. It saved country music too. It's a great thing for it. And probably the greatest thing is it sheds light on the people that deserve it the most, and that's the people that actually buy those records and buy those concert tickets. That's you guys out there. So thanks again. Appreciate it.